The history of the Rottweiler is steeped in legend. He is thought to be the second oldest breed known to man after the Afghan hound. In the first century, the Romans conquered Central Europe and brought with them a fearless, intelligent mastiff used to herd cattle and guard their camps. In the third century, the Romans retreated and on their way burned and pillaged the countryside. They killed all of their dogs, not wishing anyone else to have them. Legend has it that three of these, two bitches and a male, were hidden in Rottweil, the city of red tile. Hence, the mastiff was christened Rottweiler. And for almost 2,000 years, the Germans protected and nurtured this breed. In the Middle Ages, the Rottweiler became known as the Metzgerhund, or butcher dog. They continued to herd cattle, but more importantly, served as Brink's guards. When the butcher went to the bank with his silver, he was a likely candidate to be robbed by highwaymen. So the butcher began putting a leather pouch filled with his silver around the Rottweiler's neck, and for 300 years he was not held up. In 1888, the original Doberman Pinscher was the result of a cross between a male Rottweiler and the German short-haired pointer, and at subsequent stages, a black greyhound and a Manchester Terrier. The Rottweiler was revived in the early 1900s in Germany when he became a desirable police dog. In 1921, the Allgemeine Deutsche Rottweiler Club, ADRK, was formed. The first Rottweiler was imported into the United States in 1928 by a German immigrant. Thus, the Rottweiler entered the 20th century. I'm Murray Ross, and this is my wife, Kellyanne. And we've been breeding Rottweilers since 1976. We'd like to share with you in this film much of what we have learned over the past 11 years. We hope in this way, when you purchase your first Rottweiler, you can develop him to his fullest potential. The character of the Rottweiler reflects his pedigree. It is a combination of courage, intelligence, confidence, aloofness, and alertness. If the character of the puppy is sound, then a correct environment enhances that character. As with any physical trait, character, both good and bad, is passed at the moment of conception from generation to generation.
Only a happy dog can reach his full potential. And a happy Rottweiler is one who has a personal relationship with his family. Though, as a breeder, we must have kennels and keep many dogs, they do not stay in their kennels 24 hours a day, nor are they exercised in a compound by themselves or with other dogs. They're all walked twice a day, sometimes individually, sometimes in twos, thus solidifying their bond with me. All dogs are creatures of habit, so the feeding schedule and the order of walks stays the same daily. We literally carved this kennel out of the mountain. Before, there was only forest here. We've built 15, 16, 25 runs with large redwood doghouses in the rear under the roof. It is a completely self-contained kennel with its own septic, electric, and hot and cold running water. Let's meet some of our Rottweilers. This is Fascia triumphata. She is a perfect example of what we consider an excellent brood bitch. Her pedigree is outstanding. She's very substantial. She has a masculine head, which we prefer for breeding. and she has very dark eyes and, of course, lovely dentition. Length of the back is too long, but this is a help in a good brood bitch. For showing, it's a little long. As you can see, she's a bit robust for what you see in the American show ring today. That's okay for Holland and Germany. Her underline is straight, but at the moment, she's 7 years old, and you would expect to see that in an older bitch. As you know, the Rottweiler's head is the crowning glory on the dog. And here is Katya. Katya is a two-year-old bitch. She's a daughter of Fascia Triumphator. You can see the similarities in the head, in the type. She's a robust bitch. She has her mother's long back, but her mother's beautiful head. Okay, this is Benno. Benno comes from an outstanding line-bred litter. But I think it's important to know that he probably has the weakest phenotype in the litter. But because of his excellent genotype, he's been a very successful stud dog. Here's Boris. Boris is a 9-month-old male, a son of Fascia. He's got type, just what we want in a male. He has bone. It's a beautiful brisket, a very well-developed brisket for 9 months old. This dog's going to have a very nice top line when he's a mature adult. He's a nice, straight, strong back. Have to remember he's only 9 months old.
Color. He's such a pretty boy. Yes, say hi, everybody. We love you.
Okay.
My boss loves you.
This is Roy, also 9 months old. He's the brother of Boris, and we think he shows a lot of promise. Paulina. She's a 9-month-old bitch. She's a litter sister to Boris, a daughter of Fascia Triumphator and Benno von Ross II. She has good potential for the show ring. She's a little long in the back. She has a beautiful type head. She likes to play. Her color is beautiful, of course. The markings are perfect. Very expressive bitch, very intelligent, very rowdy. Paulina. She says Rottweiler.
That's it.
Very nice rear end. Again, the shoulders are a little broad set, but she moves very efficiently with them. She likes to show. She likes to do anything with people. She's a very much a people dog. This is Rafaela. She is an example of a correct Rottweiler show bitch. She does not have our head. This is not my favorite kind of head. She has 4 beautiful legs, and I would like to use Rafaela as a perfect example of a front. Now, if you watch, you'll see that she moves like a pendulum in the front. This is correct front movement. Also, the rear end is beautiful. Because her head is not what we want in a brood bitch, we breed her very, very closely to her 3/4 brother, and then we get the typical Rottweiler heads that we like so much. Rafaela is probably our most intelligent bitch.
This is Yati from Stroja. Also another good example of a robust, rude bitch. Not a typical American show bitch. Again, what we look for in a brood bitch. A masculine looking bitch. Substantial. Excellent temperament. Yati's ready for her Shih Tzu 1. Here we have an example of a very good, successful show bitch, Vanya von Krieter. Vanya's from Germany, and she's going to be 11 years old in a couple months. Vanya has excellent confirmation. As I said, she was a good show dog, but she was unsuccessful as a brood bitch. Her pedigree is an outcross. In other words, there's nothing the same in the pedigree. All the names are different. We bred her to three excellent males, two V-rated males, and a champion male, and the puppies were not similar in type. We had too many different looking puppies. The most successful breeding was when we bred her to a male that was heavily line bred himself. But as I said, it's an example of a bitch who is a very good bitch, who looks like she should be a good brood bitch, but we didn't research the pedigree when we bought her. If we had, we would have seen that the dogs in the pedigree are all of different types. Here we have a combination of a show and brood bitch. This is Duska von Ross. She's been very successful in the show ring, and yet she is a bit masculine. Duska has a very fiery temperament, and at the moment she's looking for trouble. Duska! Duska! Duska here! Oh, not all the way here. Here you can see my Olga in her. This is Fee von Ross. We'd like to show you her movement, side movement. Look at the amount of ground she covers. Look at the distance she covers at a trot. You practically have to run to keep up with her. The head, very expressive. Beautiful stop. Very typey. Fee! In Germany, the Fee is the godmother who rescues the little children when they get lost in the Black Forest. And Fee is a terrific mother. Here's Paddington von Ross. Paddington is a result of 11 years of line breeding. Also, you see, he has true Rottweiler type, beautiful rear, lovely top line. Shoulders are very nicely set, and he's way up there on his feet in pasterns. Okay, let's watch Paddington move. Very correct, very proud movement. Nice. Watch this. Oh, don't watch that. Paddy has a very nice rear end. Not too much angulation. He's not straight in the stifle. And there he says, I am a male Rottweiler. How many of us have gone to a dog show and fallen in love with the Rottweiler? But wanting to get involved and knowing how to go about it can be two completely different things. There are two challenges ahead for the novice owner. The first is to identify a breeder whom you can trust. The second is to learn how to raise a happy, well-adjusted dog who loves to show. Unless you are very lucky, don't fall in love with the first puppy you see. A prospective owner should visit at least half a dozen Rottweiler shows or specialties. There, you can learn about the different types of Rottweilers and identify a breeder who specializes in the type that you like. Rottweilers at 8 weeks are probably the most easily identified future champions. The great ones have a way of looking like miniature adults. Since the Rottweiler's head is his most impressive feature, I think we should review this first. We're different from many breeders in that we like to breed bitches with very masculine heads. We understand that in the show ring, most judges will only put up a feminine head type, but you'll find a few that like the masculine heads as we do. We find these heads are much better for breeding because in future generations, we don't get that Doberman look with the sloped stop and the longer nose. Okay, let's evaluate this bitch puppy's head. First of all, we look for very dark eyes, which you can see that she does have. The eyes must be very wide set, which they are, and we are particularly obsessed with the area under the eye. This is called the fill underneath the eye. We like plenty of puffiness there. We don't like it sunken in because later that will cause a longer, more narrow muzzle. We like the stop to be good. Honey, can you turn your head? See, you can see a bump going directly up. That's called the stop, and we like that very pronounced. We don't like a long slope there. And we like a good zygometric arch. That can be felt by feeling the bone over the puppy's eyes. You can feel a lot of bone there. She's not going to have a flat face. And of course, we like a short muzzle, which she does have, and a scissors bite. If the bite is not correct at 3.5, 5, and 8 weeks old, the bite will never be correct. And nobody should buy a puppy with an overbite thinking that it's going to change later because the bottom jaw will grow faster. A correct scissors bite is a correct scissors bite from the time the teeth come in. This puppy has correct top skull. She does have a little bump here, but that's due to her infancy. Right, honey, show your bump. That'll come down flat, and she will end up with a flat head. Here, let's turn her. The ears are set so that when they are forward, they make the head appear much wider, and the puppy looks very alert. The ears are not set too high on top of the head, and they're not set too low, as in a houndy-looking Rottweiler.
The worst mistake a new owner can make is to buy a pet quality dog as a show dog, thinking he's going to get it at a better price. No reputable breeder is going to sell a pet quality dog unless it is a pet. Let's see how Kelly advises a couple who are selecting their first Rottweiler.
Hi, Kelly.
Hi, Sandy. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Good, thanks.
Hi, Kelly. How are you?
Randy, hi.
Nice
I'm glad
you
came back.
Thank you. Kelly, we've decided to take one of the dogs. They're beautiful, and we'd love to have one of them. We want one that will make a good pet, and one that might win some ribbons for us, too. She's so pretty. Look at me.
Here comes Mama Baby.
Yep.
No collar, bitch.
Hi.
Okay.
How beautiful you are.
I know it's a hard decision, but we looked at the movement last time you were here, right?
Right.
And decided it was equal. So I think it's only fair that I point out a few things that may make a difference in the show ring.
Okay.
This puppy is a little wetter, we say. She may have a bigger head when she's older, but she's going to have a little loose skin. This puppy has a dry head. See, the skin is stretched tighter over her muzzle,
mm-hmm.
as opposed to this slight wrinkling here.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's another thing. Look here. See this black smudged here?
Yeah.
Actually, that is not correct. She should be like this puppy. This puppy has a black triangle, and around it, it's tan.
Mm-hmm. Is that something the judges look for in the...
If a judge finds all things equal, I have seen them sometimes in Germany trying to decide between two dogs.
Mm-hmm.
at the end, lift up the chin, look for that triangle. If one dog's got it and the other one doesn't, the one with the triangle will be put up first.
Well, Kelly, do you think that the broader head of this bitch will offset its muddy coloring?
That's a good question. And yes, I would say it does, personally, as a breeder, because I do love that big, broad head for breeding, which eventually, down the road, if you have a good dog, you may want to have at least a litter from her. But it's like a gymnast. This is a little smaller puppy, a little drier puppy, a little more correct as far as the standard for the Rottweiler goes.
If you were going to pick one of these dogs, if you wanted to show one of these dogs and wanted to be reasonably sure you would win some ribbons, which one would you take?
Then I would take this puppy, the pink puppy. I definitely think both these puppies are breeding quality, but this puppy has a little special problem that you would have to be careful of when you do breed her. You couldn't choose a male who has the same muddiness under the chin or who carries it in his line, because he may throw it. So you'd have to think a little more carefully about this than you would about that one.
She is beautiful, Kelly. Thank you so much.
You have a happy life,
darling. I'll call you tonight to make sure everything's all right.
Okay, thanks.
Bye.
Thank you.
Remember, if you go to see a litter between 6 and 8 weeks old, they should all look fat and shiny and act as though they're trying to kill each other.
You want to see your brothers and sisters? See, there they are.
We exercise our litters 3 times a day, and it just happens to be 10 degrees today. But these are Rottweilers, and they can handle it. In the future, when we talk about the pink bitch or the yellow male, we are referring to the color of rickrack, which we use as collars around the puppies' necks to identify them. Note, these 6.5-week-old puppies have front dew claws. These are the puppies' thumbs, and they are used as thumbs. I feel it's cruel to amputate front dew claws, and you would never see them removed in Germany. On the other hand, the dew claws on the hind legs perform no function and must be removed. It's interesting to watch a puppy litter play. Even at this young age, they're so territorial and so possessive.
I read, darling.
In 1973, the American Kennel Club registered 979 Rottweilers. By 1985, this figure had increased to 46,000, and in 1986 to 58,000, an increase of almost 6,000%, one of the highest growth rates in the history of the American Kennel Club. With all these Rottweilers entering the marketplace, the question, what can this litter do to improve the breed, deserves some attention. From the standpoint of producing quality Rottweilers, 2 observations are in order. The first is breeding the best of the best very rarely works unless the pedigrees are compatible. And secondly, all good dogs are not champions. With its converse, all champions are not good dogs. Let's spend a moment on the subject of breeding. There are 3 generally accepted modes. The first is line breeding, the second inbreeding, and the 3rd outcrossing. What do they mean? Let's start with line breeding. The 2 basic approaches are the Bruce Lowe theory and the common grandparent. Line breeding involves a common ancestor who must possess an outstanding phenotype. Obviously, you don't line breed on a bad dog. One of the oldest, most proven forms of animal line breeding is called the Bruce Lowe theory. In it, the sire of the dam is one and the same as the grandfather of the sire on the dam's side. Another form of line breeding is the shared common grandparent, favored by old-time German Rottweiler breeders. On this chart, the grandfather of the sire through the dam is the same as the grandfather of the dam on the male side. One form of inbreeding is known as a 3/4 breeding, which in the hands of knowledgeable professionals can establish temperament and type with the breeder's own stamp. As long as the lion carries no serious faults and the common ancestors are excellent quality dogs, the breeding has a chance. In this particular breeding, the sire of the stud is the same as the sire of the dam, a common father. The grandmother of the bitch is the same as the mother of the sire, a very close and risky breeding unless you know exactly what you are doing. And now crossbreeding has no common individual anywhere in the first four or five generations. It should only be attempted when the sire and the dam are outstanding. Generally, a litter from an outcross is not uniform. It sometimes produces one and perhaps two excellent show Rottweilers, whose breeding quality, however, is suspect as they carry the same undesirable genes as their less attractive brothers and sisters. More faults emerge from outcross breeding, and this form does not establish a line. All in all, outcross breeding is a big gamble. A very wise woman told us, start with a good bitch. Everything depends on the quality of the bitch you begin your line with. And so in 1978, Kelly and I went off to Europe. And with the help of Friedrich Berger, the head breed warden of the ADRK, we found Olga. And so the Von Ross line was launched. Olga produced Winston. And Winston produced Donya. At the same time, Olga also produced a daughter called Ida. And a son called Benno. We bred Benno to Donya and got Paddington. And we bred Ida to Elko and we got Kessie. That was the fourth generation. Then we bred Paddington to Kessie. And in 1988, after 10 years of careful planning, in the fifth generation, this puppy is the product of line breeding. It's what being a breeder is all about. Genetics is a vast subject. The secret of good breeding is simply to eliminate the negative and accentuate the positive. That is the true challenge.
We're in sunny California now, overlooking San Francisco Bay, and I'd like to introduce you to Bob Hanley, a respected West Coast handler, and his friend Ciro Von Ross. Ciro is owned by Peter Lambertson.
We have here this morning a young male who is just about to turn a year old, who shows great promise on a Rottweiler, as on most breeds. The head is the first thing that you see on your dog.
The mouth is a very important part of the head. And Ciro's mouth looks like it belongs to a great white shark. Actually, these great big teeth are desirable on a Rottweiler, as they enable him to do his work. Small teeth are a fault. Ciro has a well-defined stop and a lovely shaped head. But the head is still too immature. The heads on Benno's males generally don't mature until 3 or 4 years of age.
The top line on a Rottweiler should be straight and flat and firm. On a young dog like this, the top line is often just a little bit soft and they can tend to be a little long in body. Most young dogs do not develop their depth, which is the chest, the depth of the chest here, or the forechest until they get older. This dog, at his age, as you can see, is developing a nice forechest, and his depth is down to his elbows where it belongs. His rear should be proportional or as broad as the ribs. And in this case, this dog is very much so. The shoulder blade, which is right through here, should be sitting at a 45 degree angle to the ground, which in this dog, it does. It should meet the upper arm right through here at a 90 degree angle. The shoulder blade and the upper arm should be of equal length, but in 99% of the dogs, we have a shorter upper arm, which causes this angle through here to be a little steeper than 90 degrees. The length from the shoulder to the elbow should be the same as from the elbow to the bottom of the foot. The legs should be straight. The pastern area, which is by some people referred to as the wrist, should be firm, strong, and also a straight extension of the leg. We also want to see straightness and no hockiness. This dog stands naturally very nicely in the rear. He has an exceptionally strong rear for a Rottweiler.
The rear leg is made up of three basic parts: the stifle or thigh, the angulation or rear elbow, and the hock, which is the bone that runs between the back elbow and the feet. Ciro at this point could show a little more stifle curve and deeper angulation, but because of his short, strong hocks and powerful rear end, he drives very well. Let's see.
Let's go. Yeah. Come on, come on, let's go. Come on, let's go. Yes, come on.
Overall, this is an excellent young male who should make an excellent special. We're here in Sarasota visiting our friend Charlene Ruck, who has just helped Kessie to deliver a very outstanding litter. They're 59 days old, and I know you're going to love seeing them. For your information, Kessie is the daughter of our Edovan Ross, who's out of Olga, by Elko, and the sire is our young new stud, Paddington Von Ross. Let's go inside now and take a look at the puppies.
First, we'll look for uniformity in type. And yes, the puppies do have that. It's very difficult to tell the bitches from the males, and most especially one from the other. We expect this similarity in type because the breeding is a heavy line breeding. One name appears in the pedigree three times, twice as the grandmother and once as the great-grandmother. The temperaments are super, and this is a very handsome young lad. Here's a beautiful bitch with lots of Rottweiler type. She has very correct and clearly defined markings. I feel that she has a very strong top line, but the back may be a little long in relation to the length of the leg. Also, out of all the puppies we'll see, I think this bitch is a little too straight in the stifle. This puppy is particularly alert and showy and should be able to charm any judge. I think this bitch will have a masculine head as an adult. Uh-oh, here we go. These ears are enormous. They'll never be small, but we'll have to wait till the head grows to see just how much of a fault they'll be. Here's a gorgeous puppy who's got everything going for her. Lots of personality, little short back, pretty angulation, both front and rear. Here's another puppy with big ears. She's also got too much skin on the neck. But she's got an excellent top line and a very nice rear. Here's a nice boxy male. Look at his little short back. Can't quite decide whether to come out and see us. He's got beautiful, harmonious side movement. And he's got a wonderful head. But look at his eye color. It's too light. During the first 6 months, eye color can change, dark and go light, and vice versa. We'll have to wait and see what happens. Here's a really masculine bitch with one of the most beautiful fronts you'll see on a puppy. Harmonious, fluid side movement. And here's her sister, also masculine, who would like to say goodbye.
This puppy is 15 weeks old and has never had a leash or collar on. When you leash break your puppy, do not yell or jerk the lead. In order to make a good show dog, everything associated with leash training has to be most pleasant. The moment your puppy does it right, stop and praise him. Leave every lesson on a happy, positive note. The briefer the training session, the better, and in no case, not more than 10 minutes each day. Let your puppy win every battle until at least 20 weeks and beyond if you have the patience. That's how you build his confidence and help him develop into a secure adult. Never strike him, but rather correct him with your voice. Perhaps a little tug on the side of his neck. If he is very naughty, tap him gently underneath the chin with the upside of your palm. Remember, every correction is immediately followed by praise.
That's a boy now. That's a good boy. Oh. What's this?
Here Jim is baiting Justice. And a dog that baits intensely always shows better. Teach your puppy to learn to look at you for food. When it uses its ears and brings them forward correctly to widen its top skull, praise him extravagantly. Justice has not done so, but we'll learn in the coming weeks.
That's a boy, huh?
Good. That was good for your first time. That was good. Let me see.
In addition to baiting, it is very important you accustom your puppy to showing his bite.
Let's look over here. Oh, that was a good boy.
Another very good exercise for your puppy is learning how to retrieve. A dog that willingly retrieves is generally a happy, confident puppy.
Good boy, Justice! Good boy! Oh, that was good. That was so good.
Brush and curry comb your puppy daily. The battle against fleas is constant. Use a flea comb and dust with a flea powder when you have a problem. If at all possible, and this is sometimes difficult in warm climates, try not to bathe your dog. Nature has given the dog's skin a marvelous ability to take care of itself, and it's always best not to eradicate the helpful bacteria. If you brush your dog once or twice a day, you may find he may never need a bath. If you do run into a skin problem and you must bathe your dog, follow the bath with a Paramite dip, which may be obtained from your vet. You can use an ordinary nail clipper weekly, cutting just a little bit of nail each time. Ideally, the puppy's nail stays short when he's placed on irritated concrete. Worm your puppy regularly. Worms are one of the primary causes of stunted growths in young Rottweilers. Check stool samples every 3 weeks to 4 months. The first sign of worms is when the puppy stops eating or reduces his food intake. Fleas cause tapeworms, and tapeworms require special medication. Even if no worms are present, worm every 6 weeks to 9 months of age. Alternate Strongia tea with Panicure to 5 months. Up to 16 weeks, always carry your puppy downstairs to help prevent bone and joint problems. Socialize your puppy as much as possible. Take him with you whenever you can, to shopping centers, visiting friends, or even picking up the kids at school. Encourage strangers to talk, pet, and handle him. Give your puppy an air of self-confidence, the feeling everybody in the world loves him. A puppy so exposed accepts the excitement of a show with confidence and anticipation.
Check it out.
Now let's discuss the proper diet for your Rottweiler puppy. From 8 weeks to 4 months, he should be fed at least 3 times a day. Keep your puppy on a regular schedule. Our basic diet includes boiled chicken and vegetable, cottage cheese or boiled eggs on a rotating basis. Organ meat should be fed at least twice weekly. Nutritional supplements once each day. A tablespoon of peanut oil should be added daily to enhance the coat. The Germans and Dutch are great believers in feeding raw cow tripe, but that is very difficult to obtain in the United States. Use adjustable height feeders, raising the dish as your puppy grows taller. This aids in proper digestion and gets your puppy up on his front pasterns. We recommend raising your puppy in a crate to 18 weeks. It keeps him out of trouble and prevents unnecessary confrontations. Here are some crate raising tips. Do not use an airline crate, as the puppy cannot see out of it and it does not offer sufficient ventilation. Buy a large crate, one in which an adult dog will be able to stand and turn around unimpeded. Remember to put a blanket and chew toy in the crate with the puppy. Never food or water. And finally, during the day, try to limit your puppy's time in the crate to no more than 4-hour stints. Between 14 and 18 weeks, you may notice a problem in the way the puppy holds his ears. This is many times caused by teething stress. If you notice the puppy's ears are hanging away from the head or flying backward, the ears must be taped. Let's see how Kelly handles this problem.
Okay, now before we tape the ears, it's very important to check inside the ears and make sure they are clean and dry, free of infection and free of ear mites. That ear is clean and dry. Let's try this one. Okay, let's see, Paulina.
Good, good.
It's fair. Okay, we'll tape them, but we won't tape them for any longer than 24 hours. And if I see the bitch doing this at the tape, or like her ears bothering her, take it off.
Good girl.
Okay, Paulina's used to this. We've been doing it for 7 months. All right. We put the tape, one piece of tape, with the sticky side out. And then this goes on inside the other ear. Okay, now we have two braces. Now we're going to take the sticky side of this tape and tape it to the first brace, okay? Let's show what we've done now.
See this?
This is going to make it extra strong by taping it to that inside piece. Okay. All right, now her throat is relaxed. Put the brace back. That tape there. Okay, now the front of the ear is down. Taping all around the head so that it's harder for the bitch to get it off. Okay, and now stand up. Now you see the front part of the ear is flat against the head, and the back part is folded as it should be if the tape weren't there. Paulina. Good, that's perfect. That can stand for 24 hours. Then we take it off, see if we've tired that cartilage of it at all. May have to put it back in a couple days. But it's worth it.
Right. That's good. Yes, now you're going to have beautiful ears. Yes.
Let's say you've selected your Rottweiler show puppy. You've probably paid between $1,200 and $2,000. Now, how do you go about raising that puppy to be a happy, animated participant in the show ring? Well, raising a Rottweiler puppy to be a great show dog is similar to bringing up a child prodigy. He has to be trained to like the ring, and he has to realize from day one that getting out there and showing off is great fun.
Starting at 5 months, attend show training classes where your puppy will become accustomed to being handled by strangers. Instructors gently stroke the ears, check the testicles on males, and examine the feet. You'll learn how to stack and set up your puppy. Check his bite by placing one hand over the muzzle, fingers on one side, thumb on the other, and lifting up while the other hand is under the chin, pulling the lower lip down. Have friends check your puppy's bite. There are many tricks to correctly gating your dog, but at an early age, it is most important to get him to gate with his head up. You do this by encouraging him, teasing him with liver, a squeaky toy, or anything that keeps him happy and alert. At class, you will learn that a dog that baits intensely always shows better.
Now, Kim, I want you to come up and bait her. Make her follow your hand. Okay. Make her look at what you're doing.
See that?
Teach your puppy to learn to look at you for food. When it uses its ears and brings them forward correctly to widen the top skull, praise him extravagantly.
Come here, good girl. Good girl.
Stand.
At handling classes, switch dogs with a friend. Each class should be an experience your puppy will utilize when he's ready to show.
And crimp the leash. Okay? Pull it up over the ears, under the throat, and then you take your hand and you fold the leash. Just, that's it. Perfect. Stack her out.
Above all, showing your puppy should be fun for both of you. Very rarely do puppies win the points. A very smart professional handler told me, no dog will win before his time. One of the challenges of the show ring is to objectively decide when your dog is ready. We have found generally the bitch at 30 months after her first litter approaches her prime. Our males do not mature until 40 to 48 months, but every line is different. Here are six helpful hints before you purchase your puppy. Read everything about Rottweilers you can. Club and specialty magazines, Dog World, the AKC Gazette, and especially Muriel Freeman's book, The Complete Rottweiler. Go to as many Rottweiler specialties as you can. There are currently 20 local or regional clubs and 4 national clubs sponsoring almost 50 events each year all over the United States. Visit as many breeders as you can and look at many litters. Look for uniformity in type and markings, healthy coats, and outgoing temperaments. It all begins with a good bitch. Find out everything you can about the mother of your puppy, her pedigree, produce record if any, and her temperament. See her in person if it is at all possible. Your breeder should provide written materials on puppy care, feeding, vaccination, and worming schedules. And a final word of caution. Don't always select the biggest, tallest puppy or the fattest. At 7 to 9 weeks, look for temperament, type, bone, proportion, and movement before size.
Sita! Sita! Ready, girl, Sita! Sita! Sita!
On January 30, 1988, there was an unusual Rottweiler show in Orlando, Florida, run under ADRK German rules, which differed markedly from the AKC's. Here's how. Double handling is encouraged. From outside, and sometimes even inside the ring, the dogs are baited and called by family members and friends. They use squeaky toys, small children, even kittens and rabbits to get the dog alert and baiting.
Run! Come on, puppy!
This is truly the max in audience participation. Under AKC rules, all the dogs would be instantly disqualified.
What a good girl!
The dogs are shown in a dead ring, not a choke or collar. Therefore, they can't be pulled or controlled by the collar. Sometimes the dogs slip out of the collar, and things can get a little scary.
Watch the collar!
The handler is not permitted to stack or set the dog. The dog is exhibited freestanding, natural, not necessarily still, and constantly responding to the calls of the second handlers. The German judge does not touch any dog. He doesn't run his hands over the body or even examine the testicles. This is done as the dog enters the ring. The judge even examines the teeth from a respectable distance. All entries are given a written critique by the judge, so you know what he thinks. Every dog is rated, even a puppy who comes in 12th out of a class of 12.
Her bottom line, top line flow together very smoothly. And this is why she is the only one in the class who gets an SG. Yeah.
The German ADRK has no champion title. The elite class, comparable to our best of breed, is composed only of dogs with working titles. Though under AKC rules an open dog can go best of breed, in Germany only a Schützen-titled dog can be a Sieger. If an open dog were to win, he would not get the Sieger title. German Rottweilers engage in many activities requiring extraordinary strength and endurance. One of these is weight pulling. Another is a 12-mile endurance trot. Over the past 25 years, many of Germany's top Rottweilers have been imported into the United States. The results of this are reflected at our Rottweiler specialties. We believe German and U.S. Rottweilers today are equal in quality, type, and temperament. We also believe, contrary to what you may have been told, you will need a professional handler to finish your Rottweiler. So when you attend a show in your area, also consider which of the handlers you like and introduce yourself. Establish a personal relationship with that handler for the future. There's no tougher, more competitive ring today than the Rottweiler. A good professional handler will, in the long run, save wear and tear on both you and your vehicle, time, and even money. In German shows, the older dogs, 18 months and over, circle large rings for from 15 to 30 minutes. The judges believe the conformation breaks down after continued brisk trotting. Handlers change frequently, and if you're going to show in Germany, you and your Rottweiler better be in great shape. The judges wait for the gating dogs to tire and the falls to emerge. Then they finish their coffee and cake and begin to judge.
Little guy. Nice, strong head. Little guy. Yeah.
By viewing this film, we hope you will have begun to understand our concept of the ideal Rottweiler and how to select and develop a champion. Our breedings are based on temperament, type, and soundness, in that order.
It's a long and difficult road to a Rottweiler championship. The best advice we can give you is to have fun on the way. If you don't make it, just enjoy your Rottweiler as a wonderful member of your family. Thank you so much for joining us, and we'll see you at the specialty.